Wow, it's only 5 o'clock and it's already, the sun's about to set. And when I look at my window, it feels so late. And it's almost a winter time, it's about fall right now. But why do these days get shorter in the winter? Well, in this episode, I'm going to take you into that science. And we're going to answer a few mind-blowing questions, like, why do days feel longer in the winter? And are days really actually long? Or do we just feel that way because of the time changes? And we'll also bring up daylight savings time and many other science facts. Let's get right into this amazing and timely episode. Alright, let's get right into it. To understand why days feel or are shorter during the winter months, we have to first take a deep dive into the science of seasons. The seasons are different times of year on Earth where the climate and the weather changes. This usually happens because of the tilt of the Earth. You see, the Earth is tilted a little bit. It's hard to believe, but we're actually tilted a little bit. And this is what's known as the axis. In fact, the Earth is tilted about 23.5 degrees, which is a little slight tilt. But it still plays a big role into why we have seasons. We have all these seasons because of this tilt. Now, why is this tilt so important? Why does that slight tilt have to do with making seasons? Well, it's all thanks to the Earth's orbit. The Earth's orbit is not a perfect circle, so it's more like an oval or ellipse, and it orbits around the sun. But since this Earth is tilted to the side a little bit, that means that the sunlight isn't equal on all parts of the Earth, and the amount of sunlight on it and how long the days and nights are vary because of this tilt. When it's tilted towards the sun, that means that the seasons are warmer seasons like spring and summer. And when it's tilted away, it's colder seasons like winter and autumn or fall. Not all places experience seasons, and not all places have these big differences in seasons as we do in North America. In North America, which is located in the Northern Hemisphere, we have different seasons at different times of the year than people in South America. In fact, Christmas time for us, which is always depicted as winter and snow, it might actually be a tropical vacation for those people in South America. I know that's really cool, right? But it's because of the Earth's tilt. When one side is tilted towards it, the other side is tilted away from it. And that's what causes all these different seasons as the Earth orbits around the sun. Now, what role does this have to play in causing a time change and why days feel so much longer? Well, that's all thanks to this tilt and some more amazing science. Before we get into some more amazing science, I just wanted to remind you to subscribe to this YouTube channel below. It really encourages me and you'll be up to date on all the new amazing upcoming episodes. Also, leave a like on this video. Thank you so much. And now on to the amazing science. The length of a day also changes because of the Earth's tilt, as we talked about before. And since it's tilted ever so slightly, it still makes a big impact on our seasons, as we talked about before. But what I'm going to tell you now is even more mind-blowing. It's that these days and the sun movement across our sky, even though it's not really moving, it's just the Earth that's moving, it's all impacted by the tilt of the Earth. You see, when it's tilted closer towards the sun, not only does the season change, but the length of a day on Earth changes. And again, it varies by the hemispheres. So the northern hemisphere is facing towards the days, or the days when the sun will be out, will be longer. But if it's facing away from the sun, the days will be shorter and they'll start to appear shorter because the sun is in the sky for a less amount of time. This is because as the poles are facing the sun or not facing the sun, that causes the entire system of day and night to change ever so slightly. And that change, it causes these different lengths of days. And that's why in the winter, the days appear to be shorter because that balance or that tilt actually makes it so that the day and the day lengths are different. And the same applies to the summer. And the winter solstice is when the day is the shortest, so there's less sun and the nights are longer. And that's all because of this Earth's tilt. And it also varies because the Earth orbits around the sun, and it's not a complete circle, and that causes the lengths of days to vary based on the seasons. I know, it's amazing, right? The science, and we don't even notice this half the time because we're too busy with our lives and all this is happening behind the scenes. Now, what does daylight saving time have to do with this? Well, daylight saving time isn't observed in all US states and is not even observed in all different countries. But why do they do that? Part of it is economics, but another part is for those days and nights to line up. So for example, when it's 5 o'clock, when it's not daylight saving time, sometimes the sun can be up. But when it's daylight saving time, the sun is almost about to set. And that's all because of this tilt of the earth, and this causes those slight variations. And the daylight saving time is designed to support that and to basically help people keep track of it. Again, there's lots of controversy over daylight saving time, but the main purpose of it is economics and this time zone variation and these different lengths of days throughout the seasons. It's amazing to just think about all this amazing science just going around behind the scenes. Before I go, let's review what we learned in this amazing and timely episode. In this episode, we learned that seasons are caused by a tilt of the earth. And when it's tilted towards the sun, it's the warmer season. When it's tilted away from the sun, it's the cooler seasons. But what role does that have to play in the length of days? Well, the day length varies because of this tilt. When it's tilted towards the sun, the days appear to be longer because the sun spends more time in the sky. And that means that there's more daylight hours. But in the winter months, when it's tilted away from the sun, that means that there's less daylight time and the days appear to be shorter. That is some amazing science that we don't really know about, but it's still there and working behind the scenes. Thank you so much for listening to this episode of Spectacular Science. Spectacular Science is produced and hosted by me, Akshay J. Raman. Our theme song and additional music are by Chayan Ramachandran. Please visit my podcast website, spectacularsci.com, to find interactive activities, articles, and blog posts. That's spectacularsci.com. Also, do you have a question about science? Well, if you do, send it to me and I might answer it on an episode, and you might get a special shout out. Head over to spectacularsci.com/contact to find the contact form. Make sure to grab a parent and send me your amazing science questions. Thank you so much. Also, don't forget to subscribe wherever you're listening right now. It really encourages me and you'll be up to date on all the new episodes. Subscribe and share this podcast with your friends and family. Thank you so much. Thanks for listening, and we'll see you on the next episode of Spectacular Science next week. Keep thinking about science.